to my channel. So today I'm joined by the beautiful ladies here. We're going to introduce ourselves. I'm that girl 254.
Hi guys, my name is Alpine.
Hi guys, my name is Fiona.
So today we're going to discuss about questions about life in general. Like, we don't have a specific theme, but it will be an interesting one, and if you have anything to add, you can add it in the comment section down below. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and give it a thumbs up. So let's begin. The first question is, who is that person in your life you're grateful for? Let's start from here.
Well, for me, I am grateful for everyone in my life. I just have something to learn from them.
Personally, I'm grateful for everyone who has played a role in my success, in my growth, like everything. You know, sometimes you can say things can be hard a bit, but when someone can just come and smile at you or just talk to you, that's enough to make you happy. So that's a very big role that someone will have played in your life. So for me, for everyone who has played any part, no matter how small it is, I'm grateful for you.
So for me, I'm grateful for everyone out there who's trying to make like life easy for everyone. Like, I mean, life is really hard. We try and make life for some people easy. Some people are struggling, mental health, depression, and all that. So we try and make life easy for someone. I'm so grateful for you.
I love you.
The second one, describe a space or a room in your home that makes you happy.
My bedroom. I mean, always find it interesting. You know, like, time to learn.
For me, actually, it's the bedroom, because I love sleeping, and also when I'm stressed, I prefer being alone also. So that's how I get rid of my stress, either sleeping or listening to music or just chilling, but as long as I'm alone. And the only place that you can be alone is the bedroom. Yeah, you want to interact with so many people.
So
I prefer the
bedroom. So for me, I think it's a weird one. The kitchen. For me, it's the kitchen. For me, it's the kitchen. I love cooking. I love trying new recipes and all that. And I'm reading about the kitchen apart from the dishes. I mean, I will cook the entire thing, but I won't wash it.
Thank you.
Off topic. So, what's your favorite meal?
My favorite meal?
Yeah.
I don't have any favorite meal. Any meal which is cooked well. But I don't love seafood.
I love seafood.
Nothing. Chicken.
What I'm scared of about seafood is the stew you get. I don't know. You can react to seafood and then you can die. Oh. Actually, that's what I'm scared of.
Shoot your shot.
What is something that you're looking forward to?
It's coming.
In a week. Looking forward to my future. It's something that I'm really looking forward to. You know, like, I just want to see what has been, what's coming. Yeah. I just want to act like, okay, I knew that was coming, but okay, it's here.
Yeah. My future. For me, I'm looking forward to growth. Growth financially. I want to travel, so finances, when the finances grow, it means that I'll have the time in mind to travel the world. So yeah, that's what I'm looking for.
Mm-hmm.
Dubai?
Yeah.
Checking out on a yacht.
So for me, I think my graduation, because when immediately I graduate, I'm going to move out, I'm going to stay alone, I'm going to try new places, I'm going to like accomplish something in life, like what I have always wanted to. And after all, after the graduation, I'm going to be making money and I'm going to explore the world. What else do you want?
Other than glory. What's your favorite part of your day? Sometimes you can have a bad ending of the previous day. So in the morning you're starting a day afresh. So at least you can plan your day and probably maybe you can end up having a better day than the other day. So at least the morning is the beginning of the day. So it will give you a positive vibe concerning you the whole of your day. So yeah.
For me it's the evening because I love the evening because I'm able to journal my day. I see how it was, where to improve the following day. And I think also the evening because I manage to rest after a whole day and also put my thoughts in order.
Okay. What is something that you're proud of?
Something?
Yeah.
You're proud of?
That's
a good
idea.
Okay. I don't know, but because of future,
yeah.
Like, I can't situation. Know, like maybe when you're feeling like, okay, what am I working for? What are some of the things that I want to do? Maybe you'll start somewhere. So, looking at the current situation, I'm still yet figuring out what else to do. I'm saying that because I don't know if I'm looking at the but I know it's not very helpful. There's always a way to find information about what you're going to do.
So, sorry. For me, what I'm proud of is every decision that you've ever made that was so difficult for me. Like, every move that I thought was difficult or a project that I made. That is something that I'm proud of. Because, you know, every step that you take or everything that you do every day, if you don't have the will, you can't do it. So, yeah, for me, I'm proud of everything that I've managed to accomplish. Even if it's waking up or going to work or going to school and you're feeling you're not feeling well, like, you know, you're tired, you're in the verge of breaking down, and you push yourself and go to whatever you're supposed to do. That's something that I'm proud of. Yeah.
Basically, I'm also proud of so, like, I'm proud of every situation. Like, I find it tough, but I move out of it. Like, I just conquer it. Yeah. So if a situation was very tough for me, and I managed to go through it and come out stronger than I was before, I'm so proud of it.
Name someone who loves you. Someone you sure love.
Valentine, my friend, my boyfriend,
men are trash,
don't say
that. Okay, for me, don't say men are trash. Say your man is trash.
Oh, which man?
Which man? Everyone when you support.
Love you.
It doesn't have to be so much love. That can tell you enough love.
But can I have something? You know some people support you, but they don't love you.
How would you support someone?
Some people may support you, they don't love your children.
Oh, okay.
Are you not ashamed of yourself?
I mean, yeah. Maybe you just don't seem to be like, they put you in a situation where you can't like, you'll be there to
oh, you can't.
Right.
Are you not embarrassed?
You make funny.
Yeah, that's a genuine love without a comeback.
Yeah.
Without expecting
anything.
My family too.
You can share something concerning that. Like, yeah, when you actually, can someone really help you just so that you can become indebted to them later? Like, what do you think?
Okay, some people are genuine,
but there's someone
genuine. Okay, it's hard actually. Yeah.
What's your favorite experience in the past year? Your favorite experience?
Past year?
Yeah.
2021.
Favorite. Oh my god, guys.
I hope you're hearing this.
Yeah, I know you watch this and you know yourself.
Oh my god! Wow!
Well,
the favorite thing that I've happened to me last year.
2021. It has been my best year. Mm-hmm. 2021 was just like, it was full of ups and downs, but the ups were more. So last year, my favorite thing about last year was I started working out. And also, I met so many good friends. You watch these guys, and I love you guys.
Mm-hmm. My favorite experience last year is I managed to at least treat myself out. Like, I learned new things. Like, it's good to treat yourself. That's what I learned last year. Like, don't say something is expensive. You can't pay yourself a meal worth maybe 3,000. That's too much for food. But yeah, that's what I learned. Like, your body, you need to treat your body once in a while. Yeah. If you don't wait for others to treat you.
The sham will you cry. The sham will you cry.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah.
It was nice.
Next question. Share a favorite memory of your childhood.
Childhood. Yeah,
I'm growing
up.
Favorite.
Oh, guys, let me know in the comment section if this happens to you. Do you just ever remember things? You were literally 4 years old, 3 years old, but you kinda you have things of some activities you did. I know it looks weird, but I read somewhere about the spirit of a child. It masters something, but like, yeah, that's how you know, like, when a child grows up and then they're able to remember some weird things they did way back.
What led you to be locked up in a room?
I think I lived with my grandma or something, and I don't even remember the days I was locked up there, but I just remember myself crying and then can't relate to that.
Sorry.
You know what I mean? I think mine was bad. Like, I was playing with a dog and then instead of giving it food, I ended up playing with it, my party chakula and then I ended up spitting on it. So it's kind of humor. I have marks up to today. It's there. I'm scared of dog as well.
So mine, when I was a baby, I used to refuse to go to school completely. So this day, we were given an assignment where we didn't go to school. So my friend called Caro, okay, wherever you are. Alikuwa ananipea assignment, nafanya, ya na mark, mi nafanya, nafanya yake, mi na mark. Literally. And then, I stole 1,000 bob. That time 1,000 was so much. I bought sweets, like I think 10 packets. went to them to school illegally. Yeah? So, when this shipping came and switched on me, then my parents were called and Carol's parents were called. It was so weird and it was so sad and such a great memory.
Who is the last person to do you a favor or your job?
The last person to do your favor.
Or helped you out somehow.
No way.
Could it?
I
think it's yesterday. My friend came, picked me up from work, and yeah, that was a favor because it was kind of chilly, it was almost raining. So, yeah, he came and picked me up.
He came. Honestly, I don't remember anything. I don't know who did me a favor, but whoever you are, you did me a favor. What does it mean?
A favor, like something in you, it was like out of your comfort zone.
Honestly, I can't remember that. If you did it, I love you.
Yeah, I mean, thank you. Something
I know.
You can't remember. You can't remember, that's so bad.
No! You're not like a bad idea. You can look in the figure afterwards
in the journey.
Look in the last piece.
Name an item or food that brings you comfort. I can guess for both of you.
Yes. Don't say iPhone.
iPhone?
No.
Or anything.
Ooh. Okay.
I'm sure you will ask me. I'll feel like you.
Yeah. No, something that brings you joy.
Mm-hmm.
A food. Or comfort. Like it comforts you.
Food or something?
Yeah, it can be food.
Oh, or someone. Yeah. Or something.
Okay. Someone. Tell us. It's a he or she.
It's a he.
For food, it's fish.
For real?
Yeah.
Seafood.
Someone. I love it.
Love is in the air.
For me,
something. See, it can be something. Pasta.
That's a great food. And someone eats. My favorite. Someone who brings me comfort.
Yeah. Or something.
Food eats pasta. And someone eats my friends. Never I'm done. Just call them and cry.
Yeah.
That's it. I cannot specify on anyone but with friends. My circle didn't count.
For me, something. Ice cream. So when you see me up in the morning, just bring me ice cream. It will give me sugar.
Noted.
And then something else is long drive. Anywhere.
Yeah, we should actually.
I also love adventure, because I forgot. I also love adventure. I love long drive.
Chilling at the restaurant. Going for a vacation.
Chilling and eating.
Yeah, chilling and eating.
Yes.
What did you want to be when you grow up? When you were growing up, what did you want to become? And are you the person you wanted to become?
Like career wise or just generally? So career wise, I wanted to be a lawyer. I still want to be a lawyer, but I mean, the passion is just to draw the line, to figure. So, like, I wanted to become a a very rich girl. I was growing up. Now I'm a poor girl. I'm to be a very rich girl. I still have time.
Yeah,
I'm still young.
Come and allow.
Very young. Yeah, very young for that matter. I'm somewhere. See the complaint.
We've trained life.
I'm enjoying life.
Okay. When I was growing up, I wanted the soft life. I mean, baby girl.
What is it you're having now?
Mm-hmm. I'm trying.
Without treatment.
I'm not yet there, but that's the life that you're building right now.
Where's the girl? Wow, interesting.
Okay.
And career wise?
Career. I wanted to do something with the media. So YouTube is part of the media, so I'm working on my career.
What? So lucky.
That's when I need it. Let me hear what you want to be when you grow up. Honestly, I never had a dream. I don't know if I was the most confused child ever. I don't know if I'm still alone, but I never used to know what I really want to pursue, what I want to become, all that music on even if you want to shut up.
But I think it gave you a platform of a wide range. So you didn't limit yourself to something and then you can realize you don't want that.
So it was a bit weird of me because I used to mention like I'm taking that moment to question everything instead of working on okay, sounds good. Maybe I can consider that. So I grew in a way empathizing on myself and what they
Why don't I have those dreams?
I used to think that you sleep and then you dream of flying and then you're like, you know what? I want to be a pilot.
But I think most kids, when you were babies, most kids used to say whatever they want to become because others are saying.
A police officer.
True. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you loved the video. I hope you learned something. And I hope there's something you can also and you're willing to share about the same context. And enjoy the rest of your day or week. I don't know when you're going to watch this video, but we love you so much. And thanks for the support. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And hit the notification button.
Love you.
Bye.
It was nice meeting you guys. Yeah.